So what kind of tone you have in your email? Is it a positive tone, a negative tone? So a few years back, one of the sales guys of our company came up to me and told me that he had lost his job just because he had sent a wrong email to somebody, to a client who had who was too critical and had sent a mail just to complain and complain and complain. So he lost his cool. He sent the reply, and because of that, major client was lost. And since the client was lost, this one lost his job. See what a difference it can make. So don't send an angry message and regret later on. Take a deep breath, calm down, and then answer any mail that annoys you. There are mails that annoy us to a great extent. Postpone answering that mail for some time. So this is to be remembered. How we can do that? Just relax at that time. Don't answer any email when you are angry. And don't ask questions in this way. Will you send me the details? Even in internal. See, we build our relationships through our internal emails also. So will you send me the details? When will you do this? We should change the language. Play with words. Could you please send me the details? It's better. I would appreciate it if you could send me the details. It's definitely much better. Which one would you like to receive? Which one would you like to receive from your colleagues also? Can you do this? Can you do that? Will you do this? Will you respond on time? Will you send it to me by? Or could you, somebody requesting you to do something, a politer way of saying is, or asking a question, of course. The third one is definitely the best way. So this is something very simple we all can remember, not to ask this kind of questions. Now, look at these two sentences. Choice of words definitely matters. Let's look at our own organization. Since I come from UNA Learning and the students come to us to take sessions for spoken English, for IELTS, for business email writing, and for several other courses. So maybe somebody remains absent for some days without informing us, remains absent for about 2 months, and the course is only for 3 months. And then the person says, since I hardly attended, I want a refund. The person comes back to us saying this after about 2 months or 2.5 months. So there are two ways of answering that. I regret to inform you that we cannot refund your money. And then another way of starting it is, I understand that you took classes for only 2 months and then we continue with that. Which one do you think would be better and why? Anyone?
First one is better.
The first one is better?
Yeah.
Why do you think so, Shiva?
I think first one is showing some compassion. That's why.
First one is showing some compassion. But aren't you setting a negative tone over here? We are setting a negative tone. I regret right at the beginning of the email, a negative tone. You know, tone can be positive and tone can be negative. The person is angry that money is not being refunded because he's not attended the classes. The person is angry. And then we send an email, oh, I regret to inform you that we cannot refund your money. So first of all, we understand what the other person is feeling. We understand that, you know, that's needed. Okay, Lalit Puya, you've said the first one is following that, keep it short and sweet. However, it's important that the email states the reason as to why we cannot refund. So first of all, the compassion is when you become empathetic. You understand the situation of the other person. Okay, I understand that you've been troubled because of this. However, right? You move on to that. But first of all, you understand. I agree. I understand. I believe, right? I understand or I agree that this has caused you a lot of trouble. But, and then move on to that. So we do not start on a negative tone. We should not start our email on a negative tone. It has to start on a positive tone. Even though you feel, okay, this is a very short way of saying, I regret to inform that we cannot do this and done, finished. No. We need to have a positive, because it's all about building relationships. Remember, your client can be your apostle, can spread a good word about you, or can be a terrorist, can go and spread all wrong things about you. So whether we do it or not, we need to maintain that relationship.